Hello and welcome to Nintendo Podcast System with myself, Matthew, as well as Jack and Sam.
Hello!
Hi!
I was about to say Jason here, but he's just not here.
We've
lost him to the void of Fallout 4.
Yeah, and the day of recording, it's 10th of the 11th. So Fallout 4 has came out today, which is a greatly hyped game,
I guess. Jason queued all
but
night.
Apparently,
yeah,
it's more important than our own podcast, so that's fine. Completely fine.
Complete fail.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
This is Nintendo though. We talk Nintendo stuff.
Far better.
Let's push the Fallout 4 thing out the window.
Yeah.
A moving bus.
Thanks for ditching us, Jason. if you're listening to this, I swear this is the first time in a while there's only been three people. I think there was only one other time, and that's when I wasn't here for one episode.
Yeah, when you're in Ireland, I think.
Ireland.
Potatoes.
Now we're gonna have Aaron Ryan's music from Punch Out, who's the really crazy Irish guy.
Oh wow!
We should have that for the intervals for this one, like the victory theme.
Oh, nice.
Sneak it in.
Yeah, that is the interval. Oh yeah, actually, what I'm gonna do now, I've decided this just now, because normally what I would do with the music, I would normally do it for the opening and the ending. I would mainly choose it based off of the theme of the podcast. But now there's like I feel that there's not really generic theme really. So what we're gonna be doing now.
But Freedom Planet.
Oh, for God's sake. Well, right.
I probably will talk about that later as well, so. Oh,
it's inevitable. Inevitable.
There will be talk of Freedom Planet.
Yeah, there will be. Anyway, back on point. So what will happen is that, and to start our recording, one of us will pick an opening music that we'll just play before you hear our lovely voices. Or horrible, depending on your opinion, but if you think that, then there's something wrong with you. Then we'll pick an ending theme at the end of the podcast as well. So that's how it will work. So therefore, for my opening, it will probably be the theme to Super Smash Bros. 4, but it's going to be the Hype Train remix. So
Hype
you just,
Train?
Yeah, the Hype Train. Hype Train, sorry. Because of the Nintendo Direct that's just been announced. So obviously it's the Nintendo Direct hype train.
Choo-choo!
Yeah, exactly. Like, the Smash 4 theme plays and then people are just going, whoop, whoop, like, in the background. It's so funny.
That's brilliant.
So that's the opening to this one.
Which they've already heard. So we talk about it now. But they've already heard it.
Well, they've heard it. You guys haven't. That's the fun of it.
Tripping me out, man. You're tripping me out.
Anyway, so... Oh, wait, no. Hold on. Oh, yeah, it has been recording. I was just worried it wasn't recording. So that wraps it up for our first section. I don't know why I said wraps it up. So this is the news section right now. There's been a fair amount of news. First of all, there's been the Nintendo Direct announcement. We'll get into that in our discussion portion.
Oh, I can't wait.
Oh, it's immense. Yeah. Like,
you seemed a little bit too excited there, Sam.
That's a Nintendo Direct.
Right. He's got every reason to be excited, of course. But...
It's been so long.
Don't talk like that, Jack.
More importantly, who's going to be doing it?
Oh, we'll get into
director,
that.
Isn't it?
We'll get into that in discussion. I don't want to spoil it.
Right.
Sorry.
Ooh. Okay.
Anyway,
other
Sam,
news.
Yeah. Sam, do you want to talk a bit about news you want to bring up?
Well, I have loads. I don't know where we want to start, really. How how about, well, basically, first thing I found was the new Xenoblade X game. It was tested against Fallout 4, Skyrim, and Witcher 3, and the main open world map is apparently bigger than all of them combined.
And
does it still run at 60 frames per second?
Yep. Even with one of the fastest characters, apparently it still took him ages to get from one side of the map to the other.
That is mental.
Serious props to Nintendo for that. Well, mainly Monolith stuff.
I think it's soft. To really start showing that they can really give a good width and depth to their games.
Definitely.
The previous one like in terms of size, just out of curiosity? So I've never even played, so I don't know.
I haven't finished it yet. However, the titans are quite big, but they're not really... Like, they play in sections. Like, each area plays in sections. So you finish one section, that could be, like... Depending on, like, the story or what happens in the plot or something, it could take a while.
Right.
Especially if you explore it. But if you just follow the story, then I would say... 2 hours max, you'll be in that area, probably 1 hour in some areas.
I mean, I've played some of the others that Sam mentioned, I mean, like Skyrim and Fallout, and they aren't small games, so if they're all bigger than all three of them combined, that is going to be huge.
And
how
like,
is that even...
They've been working on it a long time, I guess they I'm guessing that they've just been working on it a long time, and I guess sought to really try and outdo themselves and make this huge map for people to be able to explore and have a real adventure on.
I can't remember when it was announced. I think E3 2015? Not 15, E3 2013.
Yeah, maybe. It was.
Or the direct before that or something. I don't know, but it was sometime around there. But I mean, still, just serious props for that, because people in this like day and age, like I say, they always undermine Nintendo. They always say that they make kids' games, and sure, Xenoblade Chronicles X, like, I wouldn't say lighter-hearted, but he's a bit more kid-friendly than like the shooter that is Fallout 4. But I mean. The world seems to be massive, but it runs at 60 frames per second, which I find incredibly impressive.
You do fight those massive, like, titan mechanical monsters, don't you? Is that maybe. What maybe they've tried to incorporate into it, or I don't know.
Probably, But I just find it great that it's able to run at 60 frames per second.
It looked really good Eurogamer from what I saw of it, quite looking forward to it.
I just can't wait. It's going to be my Christmas title of the year now. Anyway,
the next bit, for all of you Monster Hunter fans out there, it's just Jack who's interested. There is going to be a Toon Link skin for your Palicos, with Wind Waker sword included. So that'll be a nice little interesting one for linking in Nintendo for the next one.
when is the next one out? Does anyone know?
November 28th for Japan, but no Western release date yet.
Japan?
Yep, but we don't get it to for ages.
Has that even been an official announcement yet?
No, but the looks of it, it's just Japanese date. That's the only thing that's on there so far. That's a little bit annoying.
It is a bummer.
But anyway, to have Toon Link in as a little cat costume.
We've had Dante from Devil May Cry.
Animal Crossing characters.
Mario and Luigi.
Mega Man.
Yeah.
Link and Samus were in there as well, weren't they?
Armor, yeah.
Yeah. So, loads of little cameos.
So, next lot.
Isn't the cat from Monsanto or something? She's, well, it could be she, I don't know. But it's in Animal Crossing Happy Home Designer, right?
Like, is it? I didn't know that.
Yeah, like the cat or something is in Happy Home Designer as well. Yeah, I think so.
Interesting.
So maybe we should pick Happy Home Designer up now, Sam.
No.
have you picked it up?
No.
There you go, then.
But then again, it doesn't have, like, a Professor Layton house or anything.
You could make one.
Yeah, well, no, I can't, because it's not, like, a Professor Layton-themed character. But yet here is a Monster Hunter-themed character. So therefore, I should possibly pick it up.
I got to be the one to pick it up.
Probably. Like,
next moving one. On. Yep, the Pokemon Animation Studio has been opened at Kidzania in London. And kids get to basically have a 20-minute session to do stop capture animation. They get put in pairs and create little films using Pokemon, little Pokemon figurines.
Oh, like figurines?
I actually want to go there now. That sounds awesome.
How does that work? I don't understand. I don't.
Well, they're posable, aren't they? So you move it, take a picture, then you move it again, you take another picture, and then
like a stop animation kind of thing. Right. Okay, I'm with you.
So
interesting.
Well, Matthew's still a kid; he can go.
Yeah,
it's only down the road from him.
that actually strikes me as so weird. Like, it's less than a year until I'm an adult. Like, until I'm 18. Yeah, I'm the furthest thing away from being an adult. So, compared to other people in my school, in my sixth form.
I always had that problem because I was born in July, so I feel your pain.
I'm born in September, the start of the year. Anyway, Pokken News, do you want to talk about this, Sam?
Well, both can. Dark Mewtwo has been revealed for Pokken Tournament's new character.
Oh, so good.
I have watched footage, and it's pretty brutal. He's quite a hard character.
It did show off a bit of Gengar's move set up as well.
And Mega Gengar as well.
Mega Gengar. Oh, yeah. It's like very interesting.
Attack, didn't it?
Yeah.
It does seem very interesting that it's Dark Mewtwo as well, though.
Yeah, he had like a crystal or gem growing out of his shoulder or something.
It's cool, but I wonder if there's anything like story-wise that we may be getting in the spring or something.
Maybe.
I don't know if it's just for this game, because you know a lot of fighting games, they do release like the one-off dark or evil character.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Tekken does it a lot. So.
I think it was the X form, which is the power form that he evolved from, but I think do you remember when, was it Pokemon Colosseum? Well, I can't remember which Pokemon it was, but there was the dark Pokemon.
Darkness, maybe?
That's it, yeah, was it. And they were all corrupted, weren't they? And he had like
You had to uncorrupt them to join your team, didn't you, or something like that?
Is that the one with like the villain with the crazy afro?
Yeah.
Or something. Alright. I haven't played many Pokemon spin-offs, but I can't wait for Pokemon Tournament.
I reckon that's what it's based off of. Possibly. But that's just a possible theory. Yeah, well.
It's just a theory. It's just game theory. Thanks for watching.
Oh my god.
That was a horrible impression. I apologize.
It was a horrible impression. Yes. Yes, you should never do that ever again.
Cheers, Jack. Anyway, moving on. Golden Joysticks Awards happened on on the 30th of October. They're pretty big, really, in terms of gaming awards, since it's up to the public to decide, really.
Yes.
Albeit without a couple of awards being like the Critics' Choice Award and stuff like that. Nintendo did pick up some prizes. Prizes that did win was for Best Nintendo Game, obviously, and Best Family Game, both of which were for Splatoon, which I think was really good.
Woo! Splatoon!
To win the family game is quite a big thing, I thought.
Like, going up against Disney Infinity...
Yeah, it's a very impressive game, Disney, to be honest. Yeah, so.
Of course, like, Splatoon is... Wait, are you talking about Disney Infinity or Splatoon?
No, Splatoon, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Splatoon, yeah, of course.
Of course. But Disney Infinity is still a good game as well, so, you know, it's quite a tough group to sort of win, is what I was trying to say for Splatoon, and it did really well to pick it up, so...
There didn't seem to be a good amount of Nintendo fans, like, judging from, like, audiences' reactions whenever it came up or something. I don't know.
It surprises me, because Splatoon is one of the best games this year, I think.
I've been one of the best games ever, to be honest. It's one of my favourite games ever, to be honest. It's so fun. It's just amazing.
There's nothing like it at the moment. There's
nothing like it at the moment.
It's very original and...
It was nominated for original game, but Bloodborne won it, which isn't that surprising.
Yeah. I also learned about Splatoon that there was supposed to be an alternative mode of transportation instead of the kettles.
Oh, yeah.
Like it was supposed urinals.
Yeah.
Toilet urinals. I did see that, yeah.
It's so stupid.
Well...
Urinals.
Maybe you'll see that in Splatoon 2 on the NX.
Oh my god, no.
There was one other award that was technically picked up by Nintendo. Mr. Iwata was picked up for honoured for the Lifetime Achievement Award.
Which I think was like, round of applause. Which I think was like really...
Well deserved.
Really deserving. Like,
definitely.
It's a pity he's not alive to pick it up, but it's... Mm. It's quite a nice gesture.
Oh, it's definitely a beautiful gesture, to be honest. Like, I don't want to kind of ruin the moment, really, because I feel like he's kind of undermining it. Mm. But I was really pissed off with one award, which was the Innovation of the Year Award. I just want to address this really quickly. So the innovation, in my opinion, is something that can make a real impact on a certain industry, in this case, of course, being gaming industry. So a nomination, Nintendo had a nomination for it, for its head tracking 3D, for the new Nintendo 3DS and new Nintendo 3DS XL. That's innovative because it's just new technology. You know, it's really good technology that could possibly be used for other 3D capable pieces of tech. Then there was this other game that was based off of like Twitch Plays Pokemon, I believe it's like a sports game for Xbox One. I'm not too sure, but 5,000 users control one player or something like that. I'm not too sure. But I think that's rather innovative to some extent, because it's something new, something that can change, well, not change, but make a big impact on this industry. And then there was the something about the virtual reality thing in Towers of London or something like that. You know, that's virtual reality. I'm not really a big fan of it, but is it innovative? Of course it is. And then, for some reason, they decided to nominate Grand Theft Auto 5 for using first person mode in when it got ported to PS4, Xbox One, PC. And then they fucking took the prize, and it's like,
I'm just lost. That game to be converted into first person from its original perspective, it's quite impressive. But I see what you're saying. It's not really innovative. It's nothing new.
No, it's not innovative in any way.
Like,
it's a bit of a tough one to say, really. But would you say Splatoon was in there before that, or would you say the 3D tracking?
Splatoon wasn't in there. Like, these aren't counting games, really. It's something that
hardware
inside
sort of
a game. Yeah. Her story may have been in it. Like, her story, like, you know, her story, right? It's like this detective game.
I've heard of it, I think.
Yeah, same.
I saw a bit of it during Game Awards, and if that won it for storytelling and stuff, like, you know, I'll be fine. But if people really think that's innovative just to put in a first person mode in the game, And there's really something wrong.
Yeah.
To some extent, this is sort of the problem with like public voted awards.
Yeah, it definitely. Because there's a lot more people playing Grand Theft Auto than any other game out there, really, be honest. Mm. It's, other than Fallout, I guess. So, but
yeah, so I just wanted to get that out of the way. Sorry. There will be a piece on this on VG Tribune.
It's a perfectly valid opinion. It's,
But
I probably agree.
It deserves my first rant. Like, it deserves my first attack ever, really.
Well, like I said, it's a perfectly valid opinion, and I probably agree as well. It's not really an innovative thing. It's more of just a different perspective on a game, a different twist, or so to speak.
I mean, when you think of innovation, there's a lot of VR sort of stuff coming through and other games consoles at the moment, and there's this whole... Nintendo in general, we haven't really used anything hardware-wise other than the 3DS technology to really show anything else off, but there are other innovative ideas there, definitely.
Mm.
Like, to be honest, I would say the gamepad isn't innovative. To be honest,
that was a few years ago. Now it's a couple.
Yes,
years
a few
old,
years
now,
ago, but so... still, actually, you know, Affordable Space Adventures.
Yes.
Yeah, that was nominated for Innovation of the Year, like how he used the gamepad and stuff.
That's true. That was clever way of doing it.
Yeah, I can't remember like specifically. I have a speech impediment. But it just greatly annoys me that just because a game is popular doesn't mean that it should win every award. But yeah, anyway, moving on.
Yeah, we've had your rant.
Yeah. 2 weeks ago, Nintendo had its financial meeting, like investors meeting and all that. For the 6 months of this year, from I think combining quarter one and quarter two of this year, we have a net income profit of 11,466 million yen, which accounts to $95.2 million and £62.2 million. So it's great to see that they're back on track for profit.
They have,
People really love their amiibos.
Oh yeah, definitely. Like,
even after the whole Miitomo thing, the shares have started to go back up again. Mm. Like, I think it was just like everybody's disappointed and like, no, quick pull out, and then it's like actually that
pull
was
out.
A nasty move.
It wasn't really the best announcements ever, other than that, was it really? The financials were pretty cool, but everything else was just like so no real games announced other than Miitomo.
I was going to say Chibi Robo just came
out. Chibi Robo.
And it suffered poorly, apparently.
Oh, like, no, it's didn't reach top 40, which is a tiny bit concerning. Like, just tiny bit, because top 40, that's coming for everything. But it came number 7 in the 3DS charts. Number 7, and it lost to Mario Kart 7.
Yeah, Mario Kart returned to the top UK charts at number 19.
That's mental, isn't it, really? That game's been out for how many years now, and it's still
almost
one of the top
four,
games on there.
Yeah, almost 4. That's weird, 4 years now. That's
crazy.
That is crazy. But yeah, so Chibi Robo is dead practically now.
I had to look at the box. I had to look at the box yesterday in the shops, and I don't think they really made they haven't given it enough of a thing to make it exciting. And I thought it feels like they've done a bit of a half-assed job.
Yeah, well, I mean, marketing-wise, what have you seen of it? I've not really seen anything other than a couple of posts on YouTube here and there. But that's about
it. All apart from the amiibo, that's it. That's all they've done to make it more interesting. And like,
I think a lot of people would get it for the amiibo, but I think that'd be the only reason they'll get it.
The amiibo does is unlock a few bits and then makes Chibi Robo gold. And I was like, oh.
Super. Like, if I got it for free, like, I would play it, you know, especially if I got it for review, because I got it for review. But it does look like a fairly shit game, to be fair.
Like, all you do is go around and collect sweets, don't you, or something?
It's a puzzle game, basically.
It's a platformer, if anything.
With a platformer sort of pitch. It's more of a puzzle game than a platformer. Yeah.
But we may talk about this another day, but I really don't think this is deserving
I don't think we're going to see it again, ever.
GB Robo's last game. Because I feel like if you're going to try and do something new with a character or a franchise, you've got to do enough of like what they started out as. For example, Mario, like when he had to do something else, like spin-offs or something like Mario Kart and stuff like that, it's because he already had like a relatively big install base at the moment. And all other spin-offs and stuff like that. And Kirby, look at Kirby. Like that's had platformers that have been quite changed. You've got Rainbow Paintbrush and Power Paintbrush, which used the stylus to draw lines. You got Kirby's Epic Yarn, which was like the biggest outings for Kirby in terms of like new gameplay mechanics and stuff.
Yeah, he had his own racing game on the GameCube.
Oh yeah, Kirby Air Ride.
Love that.
But I feel like the upsetting thing is that Chibi Robo, he's only had one game, and that's his original, obviously, that actually is doing something with his character in mind.
Chibi Robo for Smash.
Yeah, like, I would actually rather him than Bomberman, to be honest.
True.
He could, but anyway, I haven't really played any Chibi Robo games before, but he does seem quite a charming character, to be fair. I don't know if Conan's theme could possibly be better than it, which is kind of worrying. Because Conan's theme
barely.
Considering
how poorly they
anyway.
Perform. Yeah. Anyway.
Splatoon? Did anyone play the Splatfest?
Zombies versus Ghosts?
Yep, Ghosts won. We won.
You was on a Ghost team, were you?
Yeah, we were Ghost teams.
I was on neither. I didn't even vote.
I didn't play this weekend, I must admit. I was out most of the weekend.
I did play a good amount. Like you'll see like in the what we've been playing. But yeah, in this area of quarter one to quarter two, 1.2 million units, Wii U units, have been sold.
Wow.
And
they still got Black Friday to go.
Thanks to Splatoon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mario Kart's done alright with the DLC, but
they are projecting 3.4 million units by the end of the fiscal year. So it's slightly worrying, but you know, they could always put it out with like a Twilight Princess HD or something.
It's okay because they've sold more than the Dreamcast now.
Oh yeah, it's so right.
It's not a complete disaster.
Not a complete disaster, no, but it's still a relative disaster. Actually, on the topic of Splatoon, it has sold over 2.5 million units.
Whoa.
Which is like amazing. Like,
it's good for a new IP, and to say that there's not as that many Wii U's out there compared to sales, that's probably nearly half to 40% of owners of Splatoon, I'd say. So.
Yeah, it's just amazing because it just basically hints, well not hints, but it basically confirms this is their next IP. Like, this is for sure going to be in Smash someday. Like, whether it'll be DLC or in Smash 5, it is definitely coming to Smash. The Inklings are definitely coming.
If you haven't picked up a Wii U yet, though, and you haven't picked up Splatoon, there is a bundle coming for Black Friday on the Nintendo Store. Which gets a Wii U, the Black Wii U with Mario Kart and Splatoon as a bundle. So
it's a great good deal. Like, all is a great bundle, at least.
Yeah.
So keep an eye out for that. However, if you're listening in America, I believe there's a bundle that will come with Splatoon and Smash Brothers, which in my opinion is an even better deal, to be honest. Because Smash,
and then just buy Mario Kart with that, or Smash with that one. And...
Exactly.
Brilliant deal was there. Anyway, Sam, you talked about Miitomo earlier, just very quickly.
Yeah, I did.
So, Miitomo, for those that don't know, is Nintendo's first mobile game with Dina. DNA, rather. And it's more of an app rather than a game, really, because it's... Basically, what it is that it's a communication application that uses Mii characters that resemble you, and basically you talk to them and stuff, and then they'll pass on information to your friends and stuff like that. So yeah, it could be potentially cool.
It was very similar to sort of Tamagotchi Life and Street Pass sort of integrated together kind of thing. It was, it's going to work all together, I don't know, but we'll see.
We don't know. Seems quite interesting. Like, I think Ash Poulsen from Game Explain said this. That they're sort of trying to bring in people that are shy and try to get them to open up, which I think is pretty great, to be honest.
It's good. It's good.
It kind of reminds me of, like, the Xbox Live. You get your own little avatar characters, and then they talk or something, I think, if I'm not mistaken. But I don't know. We'll see what happens, to be honest.
Yeah, it seems quite cool, but sadly, for one, it's been delayed into early next year, I believe. Well, definitely next year. I don't know if it's early or in the first half, I don't know.
Oh dear.
And that caused some of the stock market to drop down for Nintendo. But also, I don't think many people were happy with the fact that it wasn't, that it isn't a game, I believe. I believe money will, like, I'm sorry that I'm taking trouble to word this.
It's free to download, and it has character add-ons and in-app purchases on the game.
Like clothes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Which I think is pretty fair, because people will buy, like, additional stuff to make them their Mii characters more flashy and stuff like that.
From the excuses that they've used, they're delaying it so they get a bit more time to promote it after the busy holiday Christmas, that sort of season.
That could be... I think that's a relatively reasonable excuse, to be fair.
They also did mention they're looking to release 4 additional titles by March 2017 for mobile. So.
And I believe they'll be paid to download, I believe. So, like,
yes, they did mention the rest of them should be paid to download, like traditional games, not. And Miitomo is only real free download one, which could put a lot of people off, but we'll see how it goes.
But it's looking quite nice, to be fair. Miitomo seems to be quite nice. It's nice seeing how they're using Mii characters.
And they can always develop it as it goes on and just sort of release it.
Patches,
updates, constant going. So,
finally, the final sort of piece here. During this, we got word of Club Nintendo's predecessor, which has been dubbed My Nintendo.
So this is quite interesting.
Sadly, this has also been delayed until March 2016, along with Miitomo. However, like, it seems really good. I believe, sorry that I haven't read into this too much, but I believe in the same way you'll get rewards for buying games, but now you'll also be rewarded for playing the games, which I think is great, because I've put into about 150 hours into Splatoon, probably more into Smash.
It's basically another new achievement system where you get something for it. It's quite a good idea, and the fact that you don't have to purchase a game to get something.
I personally think, like, for people especially who can't keep buying games to get the codes I think it's a better way of doing it. If they make the milestones reasonable enough, but not so much that people can exploit it, then I reckon it'll go well.
But I believe this won't be just exclusive gifts like we've seen before. we may be seeing games, you could buy games with them, but you could also be able to go to theme parks, movies, and certain shops.
Yeah, and get extra things there, which is quite an interesting idea.
It's very interesting, if anything, but I also think that's great. Because if you think about it, it'll be able to bring in casual market.
You can transfer between consoles with it, so you can take your mobile out, I suppose, with Mimitamo on it, and then download whatever's on there, and then come back home and add it onto your Wii U, I guess.
I believe that's the Nintendo account, I believe. That's the thing that'll connect everything together. That's what everybody thought the Club Nintendo predecessor was supposed to be, but My Nintendo was revealed during the Q&A, and this is the new loyalty program.
It's all right.
But it's very interesting to see how this plays out. I think this would be a great way of getting people coming into Nintendo, because a lot of people in my school, they don't play Nintendo, which is hardly surprising given what's popular these days. But if they're offering stuff like discounts on movies and theme parks and stuff like that, I feel that it'll be more attractive to people now. So they'll say, oh, I could get a Wii U if I play like Animal Crossing or like Mario Kart or something like that. Then I could just get a discount on my favourite shop or something.
You might get 25% off a next game purchase or something like that.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Really looking forward to seeing how it plays out. But do you think it'll be based on how much of the game you play, or will it be an achievement system? Like if you do a certain task, you get points.
Maybe a bit of both.
Maybe the milestone bits within the game, so that it doesn't... Not just based on the actual hourage of gameplay, but also
like how far you get into the story and stuff.
Like the character you could be, or a particular event within the game.
That's pretty cool.
The thing with Nintendo is they normally target the casual players into their games, but there are a lot of hardcore Nintendo players. So if there's like harder achievements to hit to get these targets, it's giving them something to do with the games, kind of thing.
By all means, yeah.
Yeah, want to play it more.
Say example, like Super Mario Galaxy, it could be like get every star and that's what we mean by hardcore gamer, by someone who's really out to achieve every single thing. So yeah.
I believe that wraps up the news. Exciting stuff.
We did miss a couple, but Super Mario Maker, I'm sure we can mention.
Oh yeah,
playing section.
Of course, great segue there.
But the new teaser site, Fox Zero.
Oh yeah,
how can you miss that?
I forgot. I'm sorry.
The best bit of the news.
Then why did you say it?
I just did.
Okay, Nintendo site, there is a new bit for Star Fox Zero. Check it out. There are screenshots, there are wallpapers, there are, I think, one or two videos.
There's some trailers and all sorts on there, yeah.
Some really nice rendered models of the characters as well.
Is it this link? Hold on. I'm sorry to be doing this while recording, audience.
Yeah, that's the one.
Oh, yeah, it looks gorgeous. Like
that. For anybody who can't see this, it will be in the links below in the description.
Yeah. But you can pre-order now if you're in America or Canada. So go on, guys, do it. You know you want to.
But that promotional art, though, like that looks gorgeous.
Oh yeah,
absolutely.
That's what I mean. It's beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
That's probably why it was delayed slightly.
I'm going to go download all those wallpapers.
I'm going to download it right now.
Anyway. Yeah, right now. Brace you. You win. Yeah. Can't wait. Star Fox Zero.
It's going to be a bit of Wayne now for the audience while I get out my Star Fox Zero wallpaper.
Whoa, wait a minute. Oh, wallpaper, okay.
Oh, God.
While you're doing that, there's 3 to 5 new characters for Mario Tennis Ultra Smash been announced. There's a load
there's
of fairies.
There's 3 to 5 new characters for... The Sprixie fairies from Super Mario 3D World. You've got Toadette. You have Rosalina, Dry Bowser, and Bowser Jr. I think that's all of them. And if I got them wrong, I apologize.
Well... No, I believe that.
And the unused Great Fairy costume we found in code for Triforce Heroes.
Yes, there is a video on YouTube. Some hacker, I mean that in a nice way, has managed to hack into the game and find more code and found a costume which had what I can describe as a green tank top and then the great giant fairy wings. So... it's looking that there's probably going to be even more stuff, whether it's buyable content or if it's
free content.
There's a free update, then, or maybe it'd be linked in with the Trapini news that we gave last time, with more maps being unlocked, possibly.
Wait and see.
I think we've about covered everything.
With that, I think it wraps up the news.
I wish you guys could be here to see my awesome wallpaper now. It's the wallpaper for Star Fox Zero.
It's so good.
With that.
So this is the what have we been playing section right now. Does anybody want to start us off? Because I have nothing, really.
Are you still downloading wallpapers?
No, I'm not.
God's sakes. You have been playing something. You've been playing games with me, goddammit.
Oh, yeah. But, for those of you that don't know, I've appeared on Sam Spade Gaming a couple of times for Splatoon. Yes. I did play that a couple of weeks, though, so it technically doesn't count.
Still, it shows what we actually do play.
It was really fun. We played ranked battles, squad goals on Splatoon.
I didn't think we did too bad.
I don't think so either. It's quite entertaining to watch, really, though that's coming from me.
If you check the Facebook and Twitter, you can find links to Sam Spade Gaming and the Splatoon matches.
Of course. Yes. But I did play Splatoon this past weekend, mainly for the Splatfest.
Mm-hmm. How did that go?
So, I managed to get up to the title of Ghost King, which is the max you could get up to.
Yeah.
Your Highness.
You are... Yeah. and then the streak that I got up to was a plus 27.
Bloody hell.
So...
That's quite impressive.
I believe what you start out as, like, Ghost Fan or something, then it goes Ghost Fiend... Ghost Defender, Ghost Champion, and then Ghost King. How many you need to get between Ghost Champion and Ghost King is 99 points.
Oh, Christ.
Between those two titles, I was able to win every single game. And it was me and this guy called Mo with an Octoshot replica. So it was just me and him. Plus there's two other guys that stayed throughout a good majority of that run through, and my Aerospray RG.
Nice.
We just completely dominated, especially Port Mackerel. That's the easiest map to dominate on. Like, we just pushed them right to the edge, like right to their side. But yeah, it was still a lot of fun. My hands hurted a lot because I was just after doing my paper round, and then my hands were all, like, a bit crumply already, let's say.
Crumply hands.
Yeah, exactly. Crumply hands, that's the title. But yeah, it was still fun. Really good fun. And the other game I would have been playing would have been Beat the Beat Rhythm Paradise for the Wii. It's so annoying because I ordered it from Amazon and it did come last week, But to my surprise, it came in French. I came in and I looked at it. I just put down my stuff, and then I saw the cover from like a distance, and I was like, "Oh yes, it finally came." When I picked it up, like I do normally, then I just saw like a lot of French words, and I was like,
"Bonjour, je dois le dire."
What's wrong with this? This isn't English.
Brilliant.
I know I've done a French GCSE, but it's practically worthless. I can't understand a thing anymore.
Oh my god.
So funny. But yeah, so I had to get that returned, sadly. So I'm planning on ordering it again sometime.
In English?
Yeah, in English. Probably like...
Not German or Spanish or something.
Well, probably have to actually email them. Je suis anglais.
Anyway, have you played any other games, or is that it?
I've been getting through Layton versus Phoenix Wright, which is amazing.
Yeah, still enjoying that.
Really good. It's really long compared to other Laytons, I think, or at least in comparison to Curious Village.
Okay.
Yeah, still good.
Are you getting stuck on any of the puzzles on it, or is it just still quite easy to go through?
No, there are some really clever puzzles, though. I will give it that. Though right now, I think I'm at the last portion, at the last trial. Okay. It's very entertaining. Like, he plays as a visual novel, really, but it's still very entertaining, I find.
Cool.
Did you play any more of Paper Mario?
I don't think so. I'm on chapter 5, and I've just got the fish sushi, I believe.
Oh, the big whale.
Not the big whale. The just a cheap.
The purple. Oh cheap, yeah, cheap, okay. Yeah.
That you can swim on.
On the Yoshi Island.
Yeah, and I saved. Yeah, on the Yoshi Island.
So you went a bit further than last time, because I think you said you was at the desert area last episode.
Did I?
So, yeah. I think
Yeah. Then I must have gone. Like,
so you've done the Shy Guy level.
Oh,
toy box.
That one, yeah. Gourmet Guy.
Gourmet Guy. That's love hilarious. Gourmet Guy. I just, every time on there, he's just
Isn't
so funny.
Isn't the big chubby Shy Guy?
The big chubby Shy Guy, yeah. That's,
I remember you showing me that.
I've got a video on my YouTube of him, okay. if no one's unsure of who he is. Just check Gourney7789 out. Shameless plug!
Yeah, shameless plug. I have to say, I really enjoyed the third one, like Tubba Blubber or something.
Tubba Blubber, yeah, with the ghosts.
Yeah.
That's quite an interesting level.
That's so dark, like he just comes up and up straight, eats a boo right in front of you.
He eats ghosts.
Oh. Freaky.
But I am enjoying it. I am going through it quite slowly, though, which is a bit sad. I need to get back into it a bit more.
See, I started playing a little bit more of it this week, and I've got a little bit further than you are at the moment, but you are catching up pretty quickly. So but it does get tough near the last two worlds before you go on. So it's... Yeah, I don't want to spoil it for you, so I won't mention any more. But
don't know if I now prefer it to the Mario and Luigi games. I don't know. Like, I think I'm still... a dedicated Mario.
I started
Luigi
with Paper Mario, so I think I prefer Paper Mario. But,
but I just
they're,
like
they're still both good.
But I kind of prefer how Mario and Luigi like sort of gives you the idea of leveling up and stuff. Yeah. Because I don't know.
And little dances they do as well when they level up. That's that does. Which you can also see on Jack's YouTube channel.
But I also like how like your how your attacks grow stronger and stuff like by default, really. And you can buy like various equipment and stuff like that. But then in Paper Mario, like, sure you grow and stuff like that, but that's only mainly because of badges and stuff. Which is a bit
the badges
annoying.
System is. More
I do
interesting
like it.
This one, yeah.
I really do like it. I think it's really unique, but
because I use a lot of the defensive badges, and Because the way it works in Paper Mario is you've got health, flower power, and badge points to level up on. And every time you get to 100
star points,
you choose one of those to level up, and you get like +3 badges, +5 health, or +5 flower power. Flower power is just basically the special moves. You got to use so many points of flowers to be able to use special attacks, whether you use your hammer or your jumping ability. But I normally just level up the badge power and just use all the extra badges, because you can get ones for extra health and flower power from there anyway. So it's, if you do that, you can also get a lot of the defense boosts on it as the actual badges. And with the actual gameplay, you've got to press like the action button when someone attacks you to defend. And there are badges that when you do that, you can reduce the damage you take.
I think I have that on me.
So if you're quite good at doing the action commands, it can work out in your favour really well.
Yeah, it can work very well in your favour, I find.
That's why I like Paper Mario altogether. The whole battle system is so well thought out for something so basic.
Well,
it works really well.
It's intelligent systems, though, isn't it? Like, they did Fire Emblem, which I think is... Fire Emblem Awakening is amazing, really. I need to play that again, really.
They're not called intelligent systems for any other reason.
Exactly.
I let them off this one, but I don't know about Fire Emblem.
Yeah. Yeah, so what have you two been playing?
We've both been playing Mario Maker.
Yeah.
We went through
Mario Maker.
Because there's a new update on it this week. We went through and played some of the updated levels that they've added.
Oh yeah,
challenge maps and things like that.
There's event courses which unlock some of the new costumes. So one particular one is the three links, the tower links Triforce Heroes.
I really like the animation on that one. It's really well done.
Yeah, they all put out their own weapon: a sword, an arrow, and a bomb.
When you point up, it does that, but when you press down, they all lay on top of each
other.
It's just so well done. I'm just like, wow.
A second one was Arano, who's from a video game
Center
industry.
CX.
Yeah, that's it. He does a little animation that he sings at the end.
They also added some other extra levels built by
Nintendo
Bowser
stuff
and things like that, apparently. But
actual
Nintendo
one?
Built I've, levels. So.
Have you done the Bowser one yet?
I think
so
we
hard.
Might have done it. I can't remember.
Which we did eventually.
Oh.
I know we went through from the bottom to the top because I did the Budgie one first, and I beat those two. Mm. I think there's two levels on that one. But there are some really quite tough levels on there now. I think it's worth going back and giving it a try.
What was it? You're not the guide person, Mario or something.
She's on the instruction book.
My first course, like 11% completed. Like 11% complete rate on our first course.
Oh dear. There's been quite a few attempts on it already as well. Yeah, so it's...
But it is... It is a really nice addition, I find.
There is one more update they added as well. Well, there are more, but there's one we haven't mentioned, which is the hard mode on Gnat Attack.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
I still haven't played that, normal version either.
The normal version is bloody hard enough as it is. The hard version, you need two people probably playing it just to try and finish, because there's a very, very special costume for that one.
Based on from the original Mario Paint, because it had that game in that one, but it has the big like a mega fly thing, the big one, and you're trying to hit that so many times, it just doesn't die. It's like, oh come on, what are you doing? Keep dying. The hard mode one is just like impossible. You're not going to do it. But included on the update, two styluses. Yeah, I'll do. Included on the update, there was also flags added for the
checkpoints. Oh, thank God. I can't keep going through certain levels and dying and then having to start from the beginning again, because if you like, go on my channel and you'll see how frustrating it is to die and then have to start again.
And the other big thing they added to it was the fact that you could choose a fire flower with a mushroom attached to it. So depending what Mario hits the box,
if
depends
small,
what item you get out of it. So if you're small
Mario,
you get
Mario
mushroom. And if you're Super Mario, you get the fire flower. So, which is just traditional Mario, basically, isn't it? Which is good they've added that.
Basically, so, something they missed that really makes it a Mario.
Really
game.
Obvious, really, yeah. It's one of those. Have you seen any of the Easter eggs they've also added?
Oh,
involving Skinny Mario and the
door. Oh, yeah.
The door.
I saw that. That was funny.
Yeah.
I don't know how many there are, but I've seen ones of him dressed as like the frog Mario and the raccoon.
I believe there's four for every style, and I believe they take the forms of the various power ups.
Oh, there's one of him on a skinny Yoshi as well, which is quite funny. So, basically with the doors, I don't know how it works on the actual map, but there's something to do with the doors and open the doors, and Skinny Mario sort of pops his head out and says hello, so in different costumes. But,
hello.
Hello. If it's just like that, it'd be alright, yeah. Sam, have you played anything else, or should I carry on? Or?
Well, we could both talk about the next one, if you know what I'm on about.
But you don't know what I'm going to say. I could say something completely different and just throw you off course.
Go on then.
Freedom Planet.
Oh, what a surprise.
What a surprise. I've only been mentioning it like every episode for the last forever.
So it finally came out. Jack's a happy bunny.
Oh man. It plays so well on the Wii U. I love it.
I gave it a go, but I will be doing it for the channel. So.
Ooh.
Keep your eyes peeled. I have.
I'm so happy you're doing that for the channel.
I've just
worked so well
for work and technical reasons as well. So it will go up. I'll probably start next week. But I'll try and build up a few episodes to start. So keep your eyes peeled, people.
Cool.
But Jack, go into it in more detail because I only know the first bit.
Anyone who doesn't know, because I have spoken about it like every episode, but it is basically it originally started as a Sonic hacked game, but it's been reworked and redesigned into an actual full-fledged game of its own. Basically, you start off with a choice of two characters in Lilac or Carol.
Lilac, we'll explain who the characters are. Lilac is a dragon. I thought it was a cat. Carol is a green wildcat.
Yeah, with a nice little red bandana. And... yeah, it's a different sort of choice. And there's also a third character you can unlock after beating the first couple levels with either those first two chapters, called Mila, who is... it was basically a dog, but it was like a hound dog.
It
looks nothing like a hound dog.
Long, floppy ears, like... like,
you called her a rabbit at first, didn't you? So I was like,
yeah, she looks like Cream, doesn't she, from Sonic?
Yeah, I saw that as well.
I was a bit sort of like, okay.
But it's literally is just like a Sonic game. You run from one area to the end.
I think it's a bit
end,
more
kind of
than
thing.
A Sonic game.
It's
a bit more developed. There's like you actually interact a lot more and you fight more and there's like more collectibles.
Yeah. There are special moves that each character can do, for instance. So, like, Lilac, being like a dragon character, she's quite quick compared to the other two, but she's got a special boost attack she can do on the touch of a button. You can literally launch it any direction.
Yeah, that
and it
made
will
me
fly
jump.
Up for a few seconds into that direction.
I
but
pushed
you can
the button
bounce off
like,
walls. Yeah, you
what
can
the heck
push
am
buttons.
I doing?
But you can, with that attack, you can basically push into walls and bounce off of them to then give yourself a bit more height into the next jump. So if you're aiming for a ledge, you can get over the top of the ledge just from using this attack.
Nice.
So there's that attack. She's got like a whirlwind attack as a double A attack kind of thing, which just jumps up, does a little spin and kills enemies. But she's also got an uppercut and a basic punching sort of attack as well. So you've got to use all four of those sort of mechanics to play the game, because each character you fight against, you need to use a different attack to defeat it.
Ah.
Mm.
And when it comes to the bosses, you can use any of those attacks to do damage, but certain attacks will do more damage than the other ones. So, mm-hmm. a bit of a tip though, if you are playing the bosses with Lilac, for instance, all four of her attacks, if you finish the boss with that attack, you gain an achievement for it. So you've got to do it at least once on any of the bosses or for each of her moves to unlock an achievement. It's the same for the other two characters and their moves. Carol's a bit different. She's not as quick as...
She's a special case.
she's a slight special case, but she does... On the map, if you find like a little petrol can, you collect it and she can use a motorbike.
Oh, that was what those were for.
Yeah, the little red cans. That's
I was like, I've gone past so many of these. I can't pick them up or anything. You'll probably see that in the first video. I'll be like, I don't know what I'm doing.
So it's only for Carol for those things. And yeah, she goes along on the motorbike and the weirdest sort of logistics with the motorbike, because it can go again on walls and things like that. You go up walls with it. But you can also do spin jumps with the motorbike to attack enemies. So yeah, it's very strange, but it's quite a little cool mechanic. But her on her own, she is literally just like a cat. But she can do a pounce attack, then use her claws to do double damage attacks kind of thing. It's quite difficult trying to get used to doing it, but if you can get that against the bosses, it's really powerful. On her own, she does have like a kick attack as well, which is also quite good in places. But she does struggle a bit more because you've really got to target specific areas really quickly with her. Otherwise, you'll lose your chance to hit the enemies. So it's a little bit difficult. But yeah, they're both pretty cool characters in general, and you can do different things with each character and find different areas depending which character you're using. You can collect little cards which unlock like concept art and music in the game as you go along. So
I remember seeing those.
There's a good like, I think 80 plus of those cards in the game on like each level, so there's quite a lot to do within each one, even if you don't want to just finish the level kind of thing. You can go exploring and find these little things. You can get shields like basically like Sonic ones, but there's a green shield which attracts hearts towards you kind of thing, because you collect hearts in this game rather than rings. You've got like a health bar. That's why it's completely different sort of Sonic.
I thought they were leaves.
They're sort of like a leaf food sort of thing, and they never really explain what it is, but it's like a heart contain like bar.
They didn't explain a few things. I was like,
That is the problem with the game. It doesn't really explain what's going on very clearly until you're halfway in, kind of thing. So, but if you stick with it, it is quite a good little story, and it does develop as it goes along. And you've got to play through each of the characters to understand the full story, because each of them have got different levels they go on. For instance, Mila, the third character, she's got a different first level because she starts somewhere else to the other two. So there's a little bit of a one, but you got to unlock her first from playing a couple of levels with the other two. Mila's attacks are very strange though. She's a bit like Tails, where she can sort of jump up and fly wherever with her ears, despite the fact she's a dog. Well, that one out. She can generate green blocks, basically. So she can just make green blocks appear, and she basically puts them above her head and she can throw them at enemies to damage them.
All right.
And she's got another attack where she can basically make a shield in front of her, which deflects projectiles from enemies. But if you target it at the right time, you can deflect it back at enemies and they'll do damage to them. Doesn't work for the bosses, but it works for every other enemy in the game.
It's pretty cool.
But if you use both those attacks at the same time, you can use the block, then change it to the shield. It uses like an overshield kind of thing. So it's a bigger, like, sized block she's holding. You can target it any sort of direction from the left to the right and up above her. And if you let it go in that position, it generates a big laser beam in a fairly decent radius, which does double damage attacks again. So it's, there are, again, each character's got something different, and it's, you can play through each one, have different experiences each time. So it's, they're all really good, get like characters made and developed from the start kind of thing. So it's, but as the game goes on, it gets better and better, and the difficulty level does spike as it gets nearer the end of the game. But it's the main thing that in the game that makes it really good is the bosses. Each boss and every level has just been done so well. Mm. You're fighting these massive, like, running tigers. You're fighting all sorts of different things going on, and it's like, how do they even think about making these bosses and how they all work? So it's incredible. So
nice.
I love it. I can't wait to see some more from it. I know there is some extra characters coming in the future. I know they're coming for the PC release in January.
Yeah.
We should be, from what they've said, in the spring or summer, if they can get permission from Nintendo to do it straight away.
Alright.
So, yeah, it's going to be a little while yet, but it's going to add two characters in Torque, who's one of the characters you meet pretty early. I think he's got like a laser gun. The shell duck.
That's it.
The shell duck. Yeah.
That was a bit weird.
He's got like a laser gun kind of thing he uses, as far as I'm aware.
I was a bit like, okay. He's like, yeah, it's a nickname. It's like, don't read too much into it.
And there's also another character.
It's Spade. Strange fetish. Shh, don't judge me.
There's another quite important character in the game called Spade, and he's basically an enemy of all three of them. And he's going to be one of the extra characters to be able to play in the future. He's, like his name Spade, he has cards that he throws at people and it does damage kind of thing. A bit like Gambit off of X-Men kind of style. But yeah, it's a really good game, and I think everyone should go download it and play it and try it out. Like I've been saying for weeks. So,
yeah, I'll probably pick it up when I get enough money to spend on the eShop.
And if all else fails and you really don't like that part of the game, you can just go and play Mahjong. So, for some reason, they've got added like mini game of Mahjong in there. So,
for people who don't know
the tiles,
what Mahjong is, it's just a tile game where you just match pictures and.
And there is like a little mini challenge mode to like break the targets like on Smash Bros, but for this game with all three characters as well. See if you can beat your friends' times and stuff like that. So you won't beat mine.
I suppose I'm that.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much covered. Yeah.
Yeah.
I did complete Lilac's level, the whole thing, and I'm still playing for Mila's at the moment. Not even started on Carol's, so I need to sort that out. But I've nearly finished with Mila's as well, so once I finish that one, I'll start on Carol's.
I suppose the only thing I've been playing is Triforce Heroes.
Oh yeah,
I've already finished the story and done each level, even though the bloody roulette system, it drives me absolutely up the wall. But
Because you're struggling to get some of the rarer items near the end.
Yeah, there are certain costumes where you have to play battle mode, and I only need one more to get the Master Swordsman costume, and I can't get it. And then everybody else got the item.
Oh, is it the Golden Butterfly?
It's the Fabled Butterfly.
Oh,
it's
absolute
bugger. I got the gold insect, the gold dust, but not the butterfly. Although I did unlock, you know, the guy who does the lottery, the four chests.
Oh yeah,
four thing. If he later on, once you do a few of them, he gives you he goes and speaks to Madame Couture and unlocks the Dapper Spinner costume, and then you have to use the runner-up prizes you get from him to make the costume. So you don't want to sell those. You'll want to keep them because it'll help make a costume. So it actually pays to lose at them. but I'm up to about 27 costumes.
I think
how many?
I got 27 so far. There's probably still another 7 I've got to make.
Is that many in the game? I didn't realise that. I thought it was only like 12 or so from what I saw.
I'm probably about 10 to 12. I really need to get back into it. Because I was trying to play with random people online, but it disconnected and stuff like that.
Well, no, I played the other day and this guy just would not get it. We were there for about 20 minutes trying to do this one little piece of the level. Oh my god, people can be so much of an aggravation. At the same time, you get those lovely people where they just make the game fly by and it's like, oh, I don't want you to go.
Oh yeah. But it's good fun to play with friends though, isn't it?
Oh yeah, definitely.
It's really good.
I think we've pretty much covered it, haven't we?
Yep. So that wraps it up for this section of the podcast now, and we move on to our discussion. This is the discussion portion now. As I mentioned earlier, there is a Nintendo Direct approaching.
Yes! Give it to us now!
But by the time you're hearing this, it's probably already passed and you probably know everything.
Oh, god damn it.
hopefully I would have put this episode up before then. I'm not too sure. Going to talk about our predictions and even once.
And then we can see if we're right afterwards.
Yeah. Hold on. We should predict 5 things each.
Oh dear.
5?
Yeah, see how many we get right.
You can already hear Jack's brain, like the gears grinding.
Give me a minute.
Right, I'll start it off with... Right, we need 4...
Whoa, hang on. For those who don't know, it's on Thursday the 12th of November at 10 p.m. UK time.
2 p.m. Pacific and 5 p.m. Central Eastern, I believe.
Yes.
For our lovely American listeners.
Yes.
Thanks.
We love you all.
But yeah, so we're going to predict some stuff. First of all, I think it's a given that we'll be hearing some stuff about the Smash ballot.
Yes.
By all means.
They've got to reveal a character. Come on, they have to.
I'm going to be a bit daring here. I'm going to say that they're going to reveal 3.
Do you think? Well, saying that, as going on previous episodes and things, we have said there are 3 spaces available.
Right. Yeah. Wolf will be released, and then they'll release it on the same day they'll release Star Fox.
Star Fox.
That's
is
my first
now.
Prediction for Smash.
Well, I feel like we'll be getting one more Smash DLC pack before the end of the year. And I feel that's when we're getting the new characters. So I feel that we're getting 3. And I feel since it's on a Thursday, and to see how Nintendo like to bring up the hype, it could be released that day. But then again, it'll be too late for UK audiences as well, so I'm not
They
too
do
sure.
have a habit for doing that, don't they? Yeah. Releasing something during the Direct.
So. Well, it's only with some stuff. I think the one about the back at the Smash Direct at E3 this year. That's one very nice little example.
Didn't it crash their whole the shop as well when they did it?
I don't think it crashed the eShop, but he just caused high maintenance and stuff.
High traffic volume.
Yeah, high traffic, that's the word. Well, if they do release it on Thursday, they'll be getting 3 characters revealed. Because I feel that in the next DLC pack, there'll be 3 characters along with it. I think that's a given, to be honest.
It's a Gibson given.
It's a Gibson given.
That should be a new section.
That's the title of this podcast now. It's a Gibson Given. But yeah, so I think Smash Bros. Is very likely. I don't know who. I don't even want to like speculate who, to be honest. I just want to be a complete surprise. I would love it to be Inklings. I think Inklings would be a big thing. Possibly at Smash 5, but I don't know. I would just love mainly. I quite frankly take anyone at this date. Like, even if it was Bomberman, I'm not too keen on him being in Smash Bros., but I would still get him. Mm. Like, I don't want an incomplete roster, and plus, like, he may turn out to be a really fun character. Anyway, that's my first prediction. Do we agree on the prediction?
I reckon you're probably right, to be honest. I think there should be three or four characters announced, maybe. Possibly a couple of stages with them. I don't know.
Yeah, definitely. Jack, prediction, please.
Put me on the spot here. I reckon there's going to be some Mario Kart DLC as well.
Damn it, stole my one.
They did mention a while back that they were looking to do some more. Mm. And that was a good nine months ago. So...
could be quite likely, given that it's like the holiday season now.
Mm. And they need something else to sell for the game.
Mm.
So maybe they're adding another free feature as well. I don't know. But
see what happens.
Maybe a free cart again, or like the Mercedes ones. But
oh, no. No, God, well, no. Please don't.
But yeah, I think it'll be very likely. Like, probably Star Fox this time will be getting to crossover.
What, more details?
Oh, man. Yeah.
Oh, no, like crossover Fox cross in, Star Fox in... cross Mario Kart.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, dear, Jack's tripping now.
Every time I play Mario online, we play in the Mario Kart UK Facebook page, they do tournaments on Sundays and Thursdays. I always use the Fox costume for my Mii. So it'd be good to actually get the actual character, I must admit. So.
Well, they got Link in there, so I'm sure they could squeeze one more.
Yeah, Animal Crossing guys as well.
Fox and Falco, there you go.
I'd like Falco. Captain Falco. Speaking of Falco, I have pre-ordered his amiibo as well.
Yeah, same.
I pre-ordered Shovel Knight.
I've got Shovel Knight as well to come, so I'll have four amiibos by the end of the year, hopefully.
And there's me with a shelf of about 40-something of them.
Yes, same.
Oh, okay.
My super special Mewtwo one up there as well.
And Greninja is still in his little case.
God damn it, Jack! Open the box!
Open the box, you damn fool!
He looks so cool in the box.
I think that can be quite likely. I'm not too sure. But I would really like to see Mario Kart get some more DLC to keep it fresh. I haven't been on it in a while. Sam,
speaking of fresh,
don't steal my idea, Sam. Don't steal my idea.
What?
I know what Jack was getting on there.
I was. Well,
stay fresh. No. Don't give him hints.
Use deodorant. I'm gonna guess that they are. I reckon they're going to try and give us more details on Miitomo. I reckon, because they were only very vague about it. I reckon they're going to give us more details, more features.
I
maybe
agree.
Show off a bit more.
If we can, I just want to let some time pass for this sound effect. Objection! Okay. But on the...
sound effect was that? I didn't hear it.
Yeah, exactly. It's a surprise for the audience.
Just basically Matt off a fart.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I swear, it's not that. I believe on the tweet from Nintendo of America, that when they announced it and they showed the picture saying the times and stuff like that, they said specifically they will not be talking about the NX or mobile. It's only about Wii U and 3DS software.
Hmm.
So, seeing how I objected... your idea there. What sound effect do you think I put in then?
Don't know.
Objection!
Oh, God damn it.
Yay! Well done. But yeah, if you can, you can have a second chance.
Okay, I reckon they'll... Okay, if it's Wii U and 3DS, then there's going to be more news on Triforce Heroes, definitely. There's got to be something. Because if they've found stuff in the codes, they've got to give us something more on it, because there's only so much that you can get through it. So I reckon they're going to tell us more about levels and costumes.
Would you say DLC then?
I'd say DLC, but remember, is it free DLC or is it paid DLC?
I would say paid DLC for levels. I was thinking this myself, to be honest.
I think they should at least give a couple of free costumes just to keep interesting. Like Madame Couture could go, oh, I've just got some new things from a far off land, like some fashion place. I don't know. You know what she's like? She's just squeezes the cat under her arm. The cat's like, ah!
My prediction, I don't know how you two didn't say this first. I think we'll be getting Twilight Princess HD announcement.
Oh, yeah.
There'll be an announcement. I don't think it'll be before this year, myself, personally.
It's too late to release anything this year now. Unless it's like a smaller title or anything like that.
They might release... Maybe they might release a copy of the Wii version.
Maybe on Virtual Console or something like that.
On Virtual Console. That's what you have to think of.
But in the financial meeting or Q&A or whatever, Kimishima did say that there is one more or a couple more titles to come out before the end of the year, which are yet unannounced. Which are yet to be announced, rather.
Interesting.
It may be Twilight Princess HD, but I feel like if it is that, that would be a massive holiday title to be. Like, that will save the Wii U's holiday period, let's say.
They have created a Christmas advert.
Oh, yeah.
I found it somewhere. Yeah, it's like, what is it? Smash Brothers, and then there's Triforce Heroes, like the three links.
Oh,
like,
the little links were so cool.
And they like one shot an arrow and shot the top of the tree. And
there's Triforce.
That was cool.
Smash versus Mario outside, isn't there? Because there's a Mario snowman with a fireball.
Yeah.
And then there's the Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon as well.
Oh yeah.
Pokemon
game that everyone's forgotten about.
I feel that Roger Spacey made this point as well when this whole rumor speculated. He mentioned that this was around about the time that Majora's Mask 3D was also revealed. During a Nintendo Direct as well. And then this was released in February, although it was said to be spring 2015 at the time. So I would agree with Roger on that.
If it does, we would have had three Zelda games in the same year.
Oh yeah, that would be amazing. So I think Twilight Princess HD will get an official reveal. Release window, not date. I think a window is more likely. Jack, your second prediction.
I reckon Octolings will be added to Splatoon to stop the hackers from causing problems. I think it's going to happen.
I was...
The cave...
I was thinking like a Splatoon update of some sorts, to be fair, like DLC or something. So go on with your prediction, Jack.
Because of all these things with the people hacking Octolings in and playing as them in games, and then if you have them in your plaza, it basically stops your game from working. I don't know if they patched it. Maybe they have, but. If they haven't, the best way to solve it is just to add that as a character in the game you can use. Because, everyone wants to try it out and have something extra in the game. I mean, it's nice having your girl and a boy and designing stuff on them and things. But maybe you could have a separate account for one of those two and add something else in there. I don't know. But
another story, maybe.
Yeah, maybe another bit of single player.
I would love more single player. Like, I would like another single player about the same length as the single player that we already have. Because I feel if we only get 10 levels, it'd be a bit too short, to be honest. Still be great, but it'd still be a bit too short.
I mean, the game is built for the multiplayer, really. But
oh yeah, but the single player is just too good.
They have done really well adding little bits and weapons and levels here and there. It's really kept it interesting and kept people wanting to come back to it and play it more.
We haven't really got a big update in a while.
No, like, but there's been loads of little updates here and there, and
like mainly.
I think the way they've done it and put it out has been brilliant. To be honest.
No, I think there's something definitely to do with Splatoon because the Neo Splooshomatic, I believe, is set to be released tomorrow. Either tomorrow or on Thursday.
Thursday, I believe.
The only time they've ever done this was on the first update that they've done this, when they released the Nez Zephyr. This is the very first update for Splatoon, and this is when Paul Mackle was made available as well. So I think something is definitely happening with Splatoon then. I feel like.
Yeah, I agree.
It'd
be silly to ignore it now, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I think it's very likely that we're getting something on Splatoon. Sam?
Oh, God, I've got to give another one.
I don't have to, but...
I'm just trying to think of something else. I reckon they'll probably reveal maybe more stuff from Mario Maker. For example, and I think Jason, who's absent at this time, would probably point this out, about sloped terrain and other items as well.
Enemies as well, like pokies and charging chucks from Super Mario World, things like that. I think they might just add a bit more to it.
I reckon they're going to reveal more stuff that will be coming, like probably Matt said, within a later window.
They seem to be adding more costumes now as well, so maybe there'll be a few more costumes announced with upcoming games.
I think the event courses just happen randomly, though, because the Super Mario Kun level was just added about a couple of days after the update, I believe. And then you got to have the Mario Manga costume.
Yes, I've seen that, yeah.
So it's probably just be an infrequent thing with those, but there could definitely be an update.
Maybe we'll get another event post through then on this day.
Although I think it's a bit too soon to call DLC, though. It's likely, but I think it's just a bit too soon after. My other one.
Struggling now.
Yeah, I'm struggling.
You're doing so well.
I was doing so well. Just as a little thing, like I'm just buying time almost. We'll be getting trailers, I feel like, for Amiibo Festival, Mario Tennis, and Xenoblade Chronicles X.
More information.
Objection!
Really?
Oh.
Yeah, there's already been
sound effect. Video. Sound effect.
There's already been a video for Animal Crossing.
Well, no, I think just like a general trailer, like an
official trailer. Yeah, it has.
Well, no, but they always do it during directs. Like, it would be different, but it would still be a different direct.
But they've
overruled.
It's already on YouTube. They have done a Wii U trailer for...
What was that?
My microphone. Sorry.
That's the best outtake ever. Did it just fall off?
Yeah,
there is, and it explains how Amiibo Festival works.
I have seen that, to be fair.
That, unfortunately, kind of nullifies that one.
I feel like there will be at least some launch trailer or anything like that. Just like a small reminder, at least. But that's just like a little tidbit. I think my main prediction here, we'll be getting some more announcements, mainly a closer release date for Hyrule Warriors Legends, because my voice went a bit there. I feel that we may be getting more characters revealed. I'm hoping Groose. Maybe some new worlds, maybe. Link between worlds may be a good idea. You could have Yuga in there.
Maybe they'll divulge more of the story, because the story is apparently different.
I think so, because at least there's like an extra story, because that's what happens with the Wind Waker part, at least.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I believe that part happens after the events from the Wii U version. I'm hoping that they'll announce cross-transferable content. I'm hoping. Because if they do that, then by all means I'll be getting it. Because it seems, and I've said this before, like countless times, seems like the perfect game to play on the go.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I think new characters, I'm hoping Groose. Or Yuga. Yuga would be a great character to do. But yeah, and possibly a closer release date. I'm saying probably like March. Sometime in March, really.
I think release dates in general could be the thing that's going to happen in this.
Because I don't think we have anything.
Like we were saying earlier, Monster Hunter doesn't have a release date yet.
But that hasn't been announced. That's a whole different thing, to be fair.
It's been announced elsewhere, but just not.
Well, not in like Europe or I don't think even North America yet. So.
And to be fair, it's probably one of the best-selling games of the year for the 3DS.
It is. I believe.
That and Majora's Mask, possibly. With Triforce Heroes as well.
No, I don't think Triforce Heroes has actually sold that well. Or at least in comparison. No, not in comparison to other Zeldas, at least. It's sad, but. Anyway, so what's your next prediction, Jack?
I think that was my prediction. basically, I just think, like I said, there's going to be a few release dates for some of the games we were expecting and some of the games we weren't expecting. I think there's going to be a lot of one, like we said, there was two of them. They might be announcing before Christmas, or they might be announcing before Christmas before it gets delayed again. But I'm hoping for, it was in the leaked things, but there's already some Wii transfer ones, like going from the Wii to the Wii U virtual console things. So there's talks of Super Mario Galaxy being one of the games. But I'm just wondering if there's any others you could think of from the Wii you'd like to play again? I just don't really know.
I don't know.
Other than ones already on there?
Mario Strikers seems to be quite.
There was a rumour flying about of that one coming onto the Wii U, wasn't there? I don't know. Wouldn't mind seeing that. Maybe there's some information on that. But yeah, I think the main one for me is definitely release date for Monster Hunter for the new one. It's got to happen. It would be silly not to do it now. So cool.
I'll make my next prediction then. I reckon they'll give us more footage of Zelda Wii U. There's got to be more on it now. They've had a bit more time now. You'd think they'd like give us a bit more, a trailer, maybe some functions or some combat. You know, come on, give us something, throw us a bone, because it's like it's gone on quite a while now, and people need to be kept interested. So I reckon that might be something we'll see.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely. So it's all speculation here, isn't it? I mean, it could be anything they're going to announce. They could just announce, this is the last direct. Bye. It's going to be really sad, but. I hope not. I did before we come on to the podcast, I did see something about this Nintendo Badge Arcade as well, so hopefully we'll get a bit more information about that.
Just a reminder.
Seems to be just like you can. It's like a microtransactions thing, but it's like a coin grabber, but you're grabbing badges that you can use to customize your display screen.
Yeah.
So you can add like little Mario things in there, or Zelda or whatever.
It's been around. It's
a bit strange. It's been around Japan, so.
Yeah.
But then microtransactions again. It's like, oh dear. There's like... over 3,000 badges in Japan, apparently. Seems to be quite popular.
I'm thinking of one now. I was going to say Zelda U, to be fair. Let's try something crazy. I can't really think of any. Because I just looked at my Kid Icarus Uprising binder just there, and I thought maybe like an HD re-release, but then again, Sakurai's already drowned in work for Smash DLC, so that's probably not right.
Probably not.
Alright.
What about NX?
No, NX wouldn't be talked about in this direct.
Do you reckon there'd be anything about it? There'd be like,
no.
What sort of titles they might be working on? Or?
Yeah, because that's what I told Sam about earlier, is that they'll specifically not be talking about NX or mobile. Can I just say this right?
Oh, mobile. We forgot the biggest one.
What?
Pokemon Go.
No, that won't be talked about either.
Yeah, but the actual beta for it is in December.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so it's supposed to be coming out in the spring next year. So they've got to have some sort of details about it.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah. I lost my train of thought.
Oh, no. Choo-choo. It's all that hype train from earlier.
The hype train. all right. I'll try and wrap it up. Level 5 announcements. I think Yo-Kai Watch is going to get a release date for Europe.
Yeah.
Because I've been seeing that quite a lot recently with Nintendo.
It's
like,
been
going,
popping up a bit lately.
They're going
isn't it?
Crazy with the tweets, and it's like, okay, it seems like a good game. I wonder if it will sell well, though. I wonder if it has sold well, though, over here.
It does look a little bit niche at the moment.
I don't know. Like, it's got relatively decent reviews, though, to be fair. But I think this is a really crazy prediction. Professor Layton, original trilogy for the 3DS. Curious Village, Pandora's Box, and Lost Future, all for Nintendo 3DS, remastered. Everything, the puzzles, the story, visuals, everything, remastered for 3DS.
Ooh.
That's what I believe. Well, not believe, but it's just a prediction, just random. Anyway, you two, crazy predictions. Come on.
Crazy predictions?
Yes.
There's going to be a Mario Sunshine 2.
There'll be an underwater console.
They'll actually release a Mario 128. And
I can't believe this is just really undermining my idea for Professor Layton remake trilogy.
Yeah.
So my dreams can't come true.
Project Dolphin, where they actually put a game console on an actual dolphin.
For fuck's sake.
Well, you said crazy, so...
No, I mean, no, but I mean, crazy in relative terms to Nintendo Direct. Like, anything's still physically possible.
Oh, okay. Loads of indie games just coming onto the...
Oh, well, no, that's a Wii. Given.
Like, Undertale. Yes, please, yes.
Yeah.
Well, no, right. I'll accept that Undertale coming to Wii U or something.
Yeah.
That would be lovely.
That's a pretty crazy prediction, to be fair.
Yeah, it is pretty crazy.
Anyway, Sam, what's your crazy prediction?
Miyamoto will get a Yorkshire Terrier teacup puppy and name it Mario.
I want to see it. I could just see it wearing like a little Mario hat.
A little tiny Mario hat and a little moustache made of its fur.
Oh, man, the next 10 dogs is going to be amazing.
Oh, God.
I don't know. I can't come up with anything other than it's being silly, so... Oh, dear. No idea. I can't think of anything on the spot.
I'll say that we'll wrap it up. Oh, actually, finally, news on Star Fox Zero.
Yeah, final piece that's a news. Given, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a given.
That's a given.
Gibson given.
Given.
So I think that wraps up for our discussion section. So let's move on to our final section. So we are now in our final section of the podcast now. Shout-outs. I don't think I really have many shout-outs. So, Jack, do you have any Mario Maker courses?
I haven't, actually. I didn't do it this week because I've not really been playing it that often other than the quick go we had the other day.
Yeah, we were too busy playing the event stuff, weren't we?
Just as a quick one, from a couple from our group, Mickey, who was on one of our previous episodes, he reckons there'll be loads of Fire Emblem stuff announced in the direct.
Oh, yeah, I believe Fates will be Fire Emblem Fates, and the crossover between will be details.
And also Chris Atkinson's asking for a Mario Kart DLC. So, like we said earlier. So good shout-outs to you two. I do have one other shout-out in general, though, because yesterday I recorded, I was a guest on another podcast. Yes. I've cheated on you all.
You traitor.
Yeah, you are, so.
I'm sorry about that. Well, that's a bit harsh. But I was on the Man on the Post podcast. I'll put a link on my Twitter page if anyone wants to check them out.
Sounds like it hurt a lot.
Oh dear. Basically, they're a football podcast, and they were desperate, so they got me on. But yeah, they're pretty cool. They've won a couple awards the UK podcasters group. The one we're actually part of it as well. By the way, if you didn't know. So you can check us up on their the UK podcasts website if you want to see some more information on us and other podcasts you might like. But yeah, the Man on the Post podcast, football podcast, soccer if you're in America. We had a bit of a discussion about football, nothing gaming related. I did give a quick shout out to our podcast, but yeah, if you like that kind of thing, go check them out. They're pretty cool. So yeah, and you get to listen to my voice on another podcast. Oh my god. That's like the first ever like guest appearance I've had on another
podcast. Yeah, that is pretty cool, to be fair.
Yeah. I'm hoping there'll be some more work in the future. Hopefully paying work, but you know. You know, if you want me on your podcast, guys, just, you know, send a couple hundred quid my way and we'll talk. Any shout outs, Sam?
Nothing in particular, although I'll probably shout out to Toby Fox for creating and giving us Undertale. So not Nintendo related, but thank you very much. And to all the people who really helped make it. So, and then there's also all our Street Pass groups.
Check out Street Pass UK as always. We need to find out if there's a Street Pass America. I know they've got those little groups, but I don't know if they've got one big group.
Perhaps we'll put it in the description if we find it.
Can you let us know, people who are from America, is there an actual big group of you, or is it just loads of little groups all over in each state? I don't know how it all works, but
it would be interesting to know. And
I'd be curious.
Share your adventures, your events. We'd like to know, because we know how it works here.
We do the same kind of thing. So, yeah.
We had a little mini event. So it's easier.
We had a little mini event with Street Pass Southampton this week, and a few games here and there. But I also did get a chance to play a bit of GoldenEye as well halfway through, so I was quite happy with that.
Fair enough.
And I beat Jason a few times on multiplayer on it, so it was. Here's to absent friends who are too busy playing Fallout 4.
Oh yeah. This shout out's to Fallout 4 for taking away our friends. No, this shout out's or unshout out's to Fallout 4.
Play Nintendo games.
Yeah, just play Nintendo, guys. Come on.
Go try out the new updates on Mario Maker. Go on, go now. Do it. Make me a horrible level so I can announce it next.
If you haven't got a Wii U, get it. If you haven't got Mario Maker, get it.
If you haven't got a Wii U, wait till Black Friday and get the good deal.
Definitely. Shout outs. I don't think I really have many.
VG Tribune.
Our 3G Tribune, of course.
Thank you for sharing the Splatoon 1 VG Tribune, by the way. That was very nice of you to do that on our Facebook page. Sharing that about for us.
Yes, indeed.
Please do check out both the Facebook and the Twitter pages of N Podcast System. We often talk a load of rubbish on it, but they might find some of the rubbish interesting.
I really need to become more involved with the account on Twitter. Because I only go on it so rarely, so I need to do like a daily thing or something. I don't know.
Maybe a daily poll.
Not daily poll, that's too much effort.
Yeah.
Okay, a weekly poll then.
A poll
I moved
between...
across the room.
Yeah, so let's do this. We'll do a poll between every episode.
Sounds like a plan.
We'll see what's more likely. A 3DS remake of the original Professor Layton trilogy.
Oh.
Or Mr. Miyamoto getting a dog. Wait, what breed of dog was it, Sam?
It was a teacup Yorkshire Terrier.
A teacup
called
Yorkshire
Mario.
Jerry. No, not Jerry.
Jerry. He's got to be called Jerry.
A teacup Yorkshire Terrier.
Terrier.
Jerry.
Called Mario.
Called Mario with a little Mario hat. Right.
And a moustache.
Right. If we get anywhere close to that, I would be so impressed.
If we actually do.
If he buys a pet parrot and calls it Luigi, I'd be well impressed.
So that's the first poll of this week. Please vote. Please vote. But yeah, I can't really think of anything. Oh yeah, Fiji Tribune showers to like
Music Monday.
Yeah, Music Monday, of course. I can't really think of anything much. Oh, actually, showers to the Bit Block. I don't think. Like, as a dedicated follower of the BitBlock, I of course saw what went down, I believe, on Saturday. So I'll just say it very quickly here. And he basically went off on Lamar Wilson. Like, he just wasn't feeling too good, apparently. Like, just stressed out, I guess. And so he took out... Well, not took out his anger, but he decided to... There's voice be heard on Lamar Wilson's channel. And Lamar Wilson is a guy that does unboxing videos of stuff. And he gets a lot of stuff sent from Nintendo and stuff. And there's been a lot of drama concerning him versus Lamar Wilson. And he's been getting a lot of hate for it as well. But I think he's been handling it really well. Like, and he says that as well. Like, he's really head first, I guess, about these things. But yeah, he's just coping really well, not coping really well, because he wasn't really troubled by it or anything. Just shout out to him for dealing well with the whole thing very well, I feel like, with dealing with the whole situation very well. I think that wraps it up.
Should also check out both Sam's and Jason's YouTube pages.
Of course.
Thank you.
Which are...
Keep an eye out for Freedom Planet, and I think I got a few other things planned. Freedom Planet's first.
Yay! Freedom Planet! Yeah!
Shout out to The Bit. I saw them the other day. It was good to... Well, I say them. I mean Sam, but I'm sure Tom's okay as well. Somewhere. But, yeah. No, shout out to them.
I'm happy if you're happy.
Yeah, we're all happy here. Nintendo Direct is coming. Let's just...
All about the hype train.
Yeah, all about the hype train. So that wraps up... that wraps up for Nintendo Podcast System episode 16.
16?
Yeah, 16.
Oh, God.
Good Lord.
Sweet 16. To wrap it up, to... play the outro, I'm saying... I really don't know. Oh, this is troublesome.
Papyrus' theme from Undertale.
Oh my god.
No, that's not Nintendo.
But you should definitely go Google that just to find out what it is. Yeah. Something Nintendo-ish.
Okay. Let's go with Spellbreaker, which is the one of the pieces of music from the trial scenes in Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney.
Okay, then.
It's really catchy. Cool. So that will be playing us out right now. You'll probably start hearing it right at this moment.
Hopefully not, because then they won't be able to hear you talk.
Yeah, exactly. So it's goodbye from all of us here. See ya.